Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah wa alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. So this is probably one of the last assemblies that you will see me giving at school. And so for this last assembly, I thought I would talk about something which is our goal in life. That we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that He can reward us with the Jannah, inshallah. So Jannah is our goal in life. All our deeds that we do, we try and do them so we can please Allah and enter into Jannah. Now, it's good to think about the Jannah sometimes when we're feeling down, when we're finding things hard. For example, if Shaitan comes to us and says, be lazy in our Salah, or maybe be lazy with our Quran, or maybe Shaitan comes to us and says, do something which is wrong, then we need to think about the Jannah, because that is our goal. All of what we are doing, is it for Allah's pleasure? Is it going to gain us the Jannah? So when we think about the description of the Jannah, then that helps us to keep us on the straight path. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described the Jannah in the Quran, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has described the Jannah as well in many places. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى, that the next world is far greater than this world, and it's permanent. So this world, things break, things finish, things are not so great. Sometimes we don't manage to get the things that we want. But Allah says that the next world is far greater, far better, and permanent, which means that it will last forever and will never stop or end. The Prophet ﷺ said, مَوْضِعُ صَوْتٍ فِي الْجَنَّةِ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا, that the space of a whip, now a whip is a small kind of stick that people used to use to hit the animal, the horse or the camel, to make it run faster. So it's just a small stick, not big. And the Prophet ﷺ said that that space, like the size of a ruler, you could say, in the paradise is better than the whole of this world and what is inside it. Subhanallah. And if you think about all of what's inside this world, people fighting wars for the things of this world, and the space of a ruler, a whip, is better in Jannah than the whole of this world and what is in it. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونَ, that those who fear Allah, those who do their obligations to Allah, those that keep away from haram, things that He has forbidden, then for them is Jannatin, that they will have paradises. So that's plural, more than one paradise. Jannatin wa ayun, and springs of water. So springs of water gushing from the ground, always a beautiful sight whenever you go to a river or the sea and you see water gushing and flowing. It makes a human being feel happy. Maybe that's because we are created mostly from water. 70% of our bodies are water. So maybe this is one of the reasons that when we see water, whether it's the sea or rivers, then we feel happy. And in the Jannah, there is lots of water, rivers and springs gushing forward. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Udkhuluha bisalamin aminin, that enter into the paradise in peace and in safety. So this is something that all people look for in this world. We all look for peace and we all look for safety. That's why we do a lot of the things that we do in this world, because we're looking for peace and we're looking for safety. But in the paradise, that is guaranteed. Well, people will enter the paradise in peace and in safety. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ إِخْوَانًا عَلَى سُرْرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He will remove from their hearts any kind of hatred. Now sometimes we have little arguments between each other in this world, between our friends and our brothers and our sisters, our families maybe, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove any kind of enmity, so any kind of hatred that we may have, or any kind of problems that we may have in our hearts, and we will enter into paradise as brothers and sisters. عَلَى سُرُرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ, upon thrones facing each other. لَا يَمَسُّهُمْ فِيهَا نَصَبٌ وَمَا هُمْ مِنْهَا بِمُخْرَجِينَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that they, no hardship will afflict them in the paradise. So in this world, we have lots of different hardships, like hunger and sickness and fear. So in the paradise, there's none of these things. And that those people of paradise will never come out from the paradise. They will, once they're inside the paradise, they will never come out of the paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also, Ya ibadi la khawfun alaykum al-yawm wa la antum tahzanun. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my slaves, la khawfun alaykum al-yawm, that there is no fear upon you. No fear upon you. Now fear, we fear things, we're scared of things that are to come. So we fear things that haven't happened yet. So in the paradise, people will not have any fear of things that are going to come. وَلَا أَنْتُمْ تَحْزَنُونَ And you will not be sad. So in the paradise, people will not be sad about things that happened in the past. So that's covered everything. We'll not be scared of things in the future. And we'll not be sad about things that happened in the past. So a person will be in total happiness. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَكَانُوا مُسْلِمِينَ So Allah's given a description of who are these people that will enter into the paradise. They are those who believed in His signs. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَكَانُوا مُسْلِمِينَ And that they submitted themselves to Allah. So when we pray our salah, we fast in Ramadan, we read Qur'an, we listen to our parents, then we are Muslimin. We are worshipping Allah. We have submitted ourselves to Allah. So we believe in the signs of Allah and we submit ourselves. We surrender ourselves to Allah. Udkhulul jannata antum wa azwajukum tuhbarun. So enter into paradise, Allah says, you and your spouses, your partners, tuhbarun, in complete happiness. Yutafu alayhim bisahafin min dhahabin wa akwab. And that there will be servants in the paradise. It's young boys that Allah has created for the paradise only. And they will be the servants of the people that enter the paradise. Bisihafim min dhahab. And they will carry trays of gold, wa akwab and goblets. وَفِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِيهِ الْأَنْفُسِ And in the paradise, we will have whatever our inner desires want. So whatever you want, you will have in the paradise. وَتَلَذُّ الْأَعْيُنِ And whatever pleases your eye. So whatever you're pleased with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will create that there, and you will have that inside the paradise. وَأَنْتُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ And you shall be there forever. وَتِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ And this is the Jannah, Allah says, that you have inherited, that you have gained because of the deeds that you used to do in this world. So when shaitan starts to make us feel a bit lazy about our prayer, about making wudu and doing the things that we should do, then know that these deeds are the deeds that will, with the mercy of Allah, enter us into paradise. لَكُمْ فِيهَا فَاكِحَةٌ كَثِيرَةٌ مِّنْهَا تَأْكُلُونَ And inside the paradise will be beautiful fruits, plentiful, beautiful fruits that we will be able to eat from. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another place, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي مَقَامٍ أَمِينٍ That those who fear Allah, they will have a place of safety in the paradise. A place of safety. فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعِيُونَ And again, in paradises and with springs. يَلْبَسُونَ مِن سُنْدُسٍ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ That the people of paradise will wear silk. Now, silk is forbidden for males in this world. Females can wear silk in this world, but it's forbidden for males in this world. But in the Jannah, people will wear not normal clothes, but fantastic clothes, elaborate clothes, beautiful clothes made of silk. Sundusin, fine silk. Wa istabraqin, embroidered silk. So with thick embroideries, mutaqabilin, facing each other. Because when you have an enjoyment in this world, it's always more fun when you enjoy it with your friends. So in the paradise, people will be with their friends and family. So facing each other. كَذَلِكَ وَزَوَّجْنَاهُمْ بِحُورٍ عِينٍ And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have partners prepared for them in the paradise. So you won't be there by yourselves. يَدْعُونَ فِيهَا بِكُلِّ فَاكِحَةٍ آمِنِينَ And that there will be all kinds of fruits for them. And they will enjoy these fruits in safety. لا يذوقون فيها الموت إلا موتة الأولى ووقاهم عذاب الجحيم and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the people of paradise will never taste death again. So people in this world, we will die once in this world. And people are scared of death because they don't know what's going to come after it. But we know that there's going to be a day judgment. We know that there's going to be paradise and we know that there's a place called Jahannam. So we prepare our deeds for that. We're preparing ourselves. But in the paradise, Allah says that the people of paradise will never taste another death, except for the first death that they had in this world. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save them. وَوَقَاهُمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ Allah will save them from a painful punishment in the Jahannam. فَضْلًا مِّن رَبِّكَ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this is a blessing, it's a favor from Allah. And ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمِ And that is truly the true success. That is truly the true success. Now we see in this world people, we judge each other maybe when someone's got a big car or got nice fancy clothes or maybe got a big house, big mansion, we think, oh, they're successful. But this is not the true success. The true success is to gain Allah's pleasure and enter into paradise. That's why Allah says, ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has affirmed this, has made it strong in the Quran by saying three things. First of all, he said, ذَلِكَ, and then he said, هُوَ, and أَلْ. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ That is the true success. So Allah has made this firm in three ways. So if we're trying to be successful, then the good deeds that we do, that will lead us to the true success. Now the Prophet ﷺ said, يَأْكُلُ أَحْلُ الْجَنَّةَ فِيهَا That the people of the paradise, they will eat inside the paradise. وَيَشْرَبُونَ And they will drink inside the paradise. وَلَا يَتَغَوَّتُونَ وَلَا يَمْخَطُونَ And that the Prophet ﷺ said that they will not go to the toilet. They don't go to do big toilet. Or they will not have snot coming from their nose. Yeah. وَلَا يَبُولُونَ And they will not do small toilet. So people in the paradise will not go to the toilet at all. وَلَكِنْ طَعَامُهُمْ ذَلِكَ جُشَاءٌ That their food will be, it will be the food that they, the products that they don't need from the food will come out like a belt on you belch. So basically like burping. كَرَشْهِ الْمِسْكِ But it won't smell bad like it smells in this world, but it will smell of perfume. So when they burp, it will smell of perfume. يُلْهِمُونَ التَّسْبِيحَ وَالتَّكْبِيرَ كَمَا يُلْهِمُونَ النَّفْسِ So the people of paradise will worship Allah. We will worship Allah, inshallah, in the paradise. But it will not be difficult like it is in this world. In this world, it's difficult because we have shaitan whispering there. Sometimes we feel lazy, sometimes we feel tired. So worshipping Allah can sometimes be difficult in this world. But in the paradise, it won't be. And it will be as easy as we find it to breathe in this world. So like when we breathe, we take a breath, we don't even think about breathing. So even when we're sleeping, we're breathing. In the paradise, that's how we will say Subhanallah, Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillah, and we will worship Allah in that way, just as we find it easy to breathe in this world. Now the Prophet ﷺ said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَعْدَدْتُ لِعِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحِينَ That I have prepared for my pious worshippers. مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ مَا لَا عَيْنَ رَأَتْ That which no eye has seen. وَلَا أُذُنَ سَمِعَتْ And that no ear has heard. وَلَا خَطْرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ And that it hasn't even occurred to the heart of any human being. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created fantastic things that no eye has seen, no ear has heard, and not even any person has even thought of before. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, اقرأوا إن شئتم فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين That a person does not know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created in the paradise. من قرة أعين That which will please their eyes. جزاء بما كانوا يعملون As a reward for that which they have done in this world. Now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said in a hadith, أول زمرة يدخلون الجنة على سورة القمر That the first group of people to enter the paradise, their faces will be as bright as the moon. Laylatul Badr, on the full moon. So when you see the full moon in the night at night time, you see how bright it is. Then the people's faces, that the first group of people that will enter the paradise, their faces will be as bright as that. ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ عَلَىٰ أَشَدِّ كَوْكَبٍ دُرِّيٍ فِي السَّمَاءِ إِضَاءً And then the next group of people that will enter the paradise, their faces will be as bright as the shining star the brightest shining star that you see in the sky. So the people in the paradise will be leveled. So not everybody that enters paradise will have the same level of paradise. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Inni la a'lamu akhira ahla an-nari khurujan minha." The Prophet ﷺ said, "I know the last person that will come out of the hellfire." So the Prophet ﷺ, he knew things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told him from the unseen. So Allah had told him, Jibreel comes and tells him sometimes, and he knew things that we obviously don't know. And here the Prophet ﷺ is saying that he knows the last person that will come out from Jahannam. وَآخِرْ أَهْلُ جَنَّةِ دُخُولًا الْجَنَّةِ. And he knows the last person that will enter into paradise. رَجُلٌ يَخْرُجُ مِنَ النَّارِ حَبْوًا. And the Prophet ﷺ said it will be a man that comes out crawling from the hellfire. فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّهُ. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to this man, اِذْعَبْ فَدُخُلْ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to this man, go and enter into the paradise. فَيَأْتِيهَا فَيُخَيُّلَ إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهَا مَلَأَ. So the man will come to the paradise and he will think that it is full. فَيَرَجْعُ فَيَقُولُ يَا رَبِّ وَجَدْتُهَا مَلَأَ. And so the man will go back to Allah and he will say, oh my Lord, I found that it is full. فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّهُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, اِذْحَبْ فَدْخُلِ الْجَنَّةِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, go and enter into the paradise. فَيُخَيِّلُ إِلَيْهِ فَيَأْتِيهَا فَيُخَيِّلُ إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهَا مَلَأَ. And so the man will return back to the paradise and he will think again that it is full. فَيَرُجْعُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي وَجَدْتُهَا مَلَأَ. And so he will go back sad to Allah and he will say, oh my Lord, I found that it is full. فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّهُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, اِذْهَبْ فَدْخُلِ الْجَنَّةِ. And Allah will say, go and enter into paradise. فَإِنَّ لَكَ مِثْلُ الدُّنْيَا وَعَشْرَةُ أَمْثَالِهَا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, this is the last man, remember, the last man to come out of Jahannam. And Allah will say, go to the Jannah, and you will have a Jannah which is like the dunya, like this world, and 10 times the size of it. And 10 times the size of this dunya. So imagine how big this world is, of all the countries. Even imagine how big this country is, the UK that we're living in. We haven't been to every city, we haven't been to every place, we haven't been to every park. And that's just this country. Imagine all of the countries of the world. Imagine the whole world. And this last man that will come out of Jahannam, he will have a paradise which is 10 times the size of this world. And so the man will say, فَيَقُولُ أَتَسْخَرَ بِي أَوْ تَضْحَكُ بِي وَأَنْتَ الْمَلِكُ. And the man will say, oh Allah, are you joking with me? And you are the Lord of the world. And you are the Lord and the King. And at this point, the Prophet ﷺ laughed until you could see his molar teeth, his back teeth. And the Prophet ﷺ said, ذَلِكَ أَدْنَى أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ مَنْزِلًا. The Prophet ﷺ said, and that is the lowest level in the paradise. So imagine the lowest level in the paradise is 10 times the size of this world. The Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ لِلْمُؤْمِنِ فِي الْجَنَّةِ لَخَيْمَةً. That inside the paradise, the believer will have a tent, but it's not an ordinary tent. لَخَيْمَةٌ مِّن لُؤْلُؤٍ وَاحِدَةٍ مُجَوَّفَةً. That this tent will be made of a pearl, and it will be hollow, like a hollow pearl. طُولُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ سِتُّونَ مِيلًا. That this tent, which is like a hollow pearl, will be so big that it will be 60 miles high into the sky. لِلْمُؤْمِنِ فِيهَا أَهْلُونَ. So, and the believer will have families. So his family will be living inside this beautiful tent of pearl. يَطُوفُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ الْمُؤْمِنِ. And the believer will go from one family to another family. فَلَا يَرَى بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا. And each family will not see each other, but he will visit all of his different families inside this huge tent like a pearl. Also the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ فِي الْجَنَّةِ لَشَجْرَةٌ يُسِيرُ الرَّاقِبُ الْجَوَادُ الْمُدْمِرُ السَّرِيعُ مِئَةَ سَنَةٍ مَا يَقْطَعُهَا. That the Prophet ﷺ said that indeed in the paradise there's trees, and the tree is so huge that even if a fast horseman on a horse, galloping, running fast on his horse, would not go around this tree, even if it took him 100 years. So it would take him 100 years to go just past around this street. That's how huge this street is. And remember, every single time you say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is planting a tree for you in paradise. So imagine how big a paradise you could have with so many trees inside the paradise. Also, the Prophet said, Inna ahl jannati layatara'una ahl al-ghurafi fawqahum kama tatara'una kawkab al-durri al-ghabir fi al-ufqi min al-mashriqi aw al-maghribi litafadulihim ma baynahum. The Prophet said that the people of paradise, they will see these people, these other people high up, like in a room high up, high in the sky, like you see a star. And these will be people in another paradise that is so higher than them that they can see these people, but can just see them only like a star in the sky. And the companions, and the Prophet ﷺ said that is the distance between them because of their deeds. So one set of people are higher than another set of people because of they done better deeds than the lower people. So the companions, they said, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, Tilka manazilu anbiya, la yablughaha ghayru. And the companions, they said, are these people, are they prophets? Are they the prophets of Allah? And that nobody could reach their level because they're such good people. And the Prophet ﷺ said, Bala walladhi nafsi biyadih. And the Prophet ﷺ said, No, by the one who holds my soul in his hand. Rijalun amanu billah, that they are people that believed in Allah, wa sadaqul mursaleen, and that they believed in his messengers. So if we believe in Allah and we believe in his messengers and we do the correct deeds, we can have this high station in the paradise, inshallah. The Prophet ﷺ said, Inna fil jannati suqan ya'tunaha kullu jum'ah. For in the paradise there is a marketplace, and the people at the paradise will go to this marketplace every Friday. Fatahabu riha shimal, and the northern wind will blow. Fatahathu fi wujuhim wa thiyabihim, and this wind will come and blow inside their faces and in their clothes. Fayazdaduna husnan wa jimalan, and this wind is no ordinary wind. It will make them more beautiful and more handsome. فَيَرْجِعُونَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِمْ, and so they will go back after this marketplace to their families. وَقَدْ ازْدَادُوا حُسْنًا وَجِمَالًا, and they have increased in beauty and handsomeness. فَيَقُولُ لَهُمْ أَهْلُهُمْ, and their family will say to them, وَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ ازْدَدْتُمْ حُسْنًا وَجِمَالًا, that by Allah, you have become more handsome and more beautiful since you've gone. فَيَقُولُونَ وَأَنْتُمْ وَاللَّهِ قَدْ ازْدَدْتُمْ بَعْدَنَا حُسْنًا وَجِمَالًا, and then they will say to their families, and you as well have increased in beauty and have become more handsome since we have gone. So every Friday the people of paradise will go to this marketplace. They will increase them, Allah will increase them with this wind in beauty, and when they return they will find that their families as well have been increased in beauty. The Prophet ﷺ said, إِذَا دَخَلَ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ الْجَنَّةِ يُنَادِي مُنَادٍ. So when the people of paradise, they enter the paradise, a caller will announce, إِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَحْيُوا فَلَا تَمُوتُوا أَبَدًا. That this caller will announce that you will live in here in the paradise forever and you will never die. وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَسِحُوا فَلَا تَسْقَمُوا أَبَدًا. And that you will be healthy and you will never become sick ever. وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَشْبُوا وَلَا تَحْرَمُوا أَبَدًا, and that you will be young, youthful, and you will never become old. وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَنْعَمُوا فَلَا تَيْأَسُوا أَبَدًا, and that you will have the blessings of Allah and you will never become wretched. You will never suffer any harm. So the people of paradise will have all of the things that you could possibly wish, that you will live forever. Now, there are people in this world that are trying, scientists, and they're trying to find a way to live forever. But that's not possible in this world. That's in the Jannah. And those people that have become sick, when you're sick, you know how hard it is. If you have pain and you're not well, you can't do the things that you used to do, it's not nice being sick. And in the paradise, people will never be sick. And you people are still small, but when you become old, again, you return like a small baby, and you find things that were easy for you, you find them hard again. So in the paradise, you will stay young, you'll never become old. And you'll have all of the most beautiful things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will create. New things, and you will never, never have any harm or suffer any hardship. Prophet said, "Inna adna maq'ada ahdikum min al-jannati an yaqulu tamanna fayatamanna wa yatamanna." That the lowest position, the lowest level in the paradise that a person can have, it will be said to them, tamanna, that wish, make a wish, wa yatamanna, and make more wishes. Fayaqulu lahu hal tamannayta, and then it will be said to him, have you made as many wishes as you want? فَيَقُولُ نَعَمْ, and that person will say yes. فَيَقُولُ لَهُ فَإِنَّ لَكَ مَا تَمَنَّيْتَ وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَ, that for you will be what you have wished and a similar amount with it. So a person will wish and wish for as much as they wish for their heart's desire, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them that and extra on top of that as well. Prophet said, "Inna Allah Azza wa Jalla yaqulu li ahli al-Jannah," that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to the people of Jannah, "Fayaqulun labbaik ya wa saddaik." So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, "Ya ahli al-Jannah," O people of paradise, "Fayaqulun labbaik wa saddaik." And so the people of paradise will say, "Oh, we listen, we are at your command, O Allah, and at your happiness, O Allah. Wa al-khayra fi yadayk, and all good is in your hands." فَيَقُولُ هَلْ رَضِيْتُمْ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the people of paradise, "How are you pleased?" فَيَقُولُ مَا لَنَا لَا نَرْضَى يَا رَبَّنَا, they will say, "Oh our Lord, how can we not be pleased? وَقَدْ آتَيْتَنَا مَا لَمْ تُعْطِ أَحَدًا مِنْ خَلْقِكَ, and you have given us that which you have not given anything to anybody else in your creation." Subhanallah, think about that. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the people of paradise that which He has not given any other creature. So even the angels of Allah, most beloved angels of Allah, Jibreel, Mikael, all of these beloved angels, that Allah's the people of paradise will say that He has given them, the people of paradise, that which He has not given any other creation. فَيَقُولُ أَلَا أَعْطَيْتُكُمْ أَفْضَلُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, "Should I not give you better than that?" فَيَقُولُونَ وَأَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَفْضَلُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ, and the people of paradise will say, "What can be better than what you have given us already?" فَيَقُولُ أُحِلُّ عَلَيْكُمْ رِضْوَانِي فَلَا أَسْخَطُ عَلَيْكُمْ بَعْدَهُ أَبَدًا, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say that I will give you my pleasure, that know that my pleasure is upon you, and that I will never become angry with you ever. Subhanallah. So if you think about it, the pleasure of Allah is the greatest thing, is greater than the paradise and anything that we could possibly imagine. Pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making Allah the creator of the Lord of the whole world, of the whole of creation, making Him pleased is the greatest thing that we could possibly have, better than the Jannah itself. Prophet ﷺ said, one time the Prophet ﷺ and the companions, they were gazing into the sky at night, and they saw the full moon. They saw the full moon, and the Prophet ﷺ said, "Innakum sitarawna rabbukum ayanan kama tarawna hadha al-qamar," that you will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just as you see this moon. "La tadamuna fi ru'yati," that you will not find any difficulty in seeing Allah. So seeing Allah is the greatest, greatest pleasure in the paradise. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "إذا دخل أهل الجنة الجنة فيقول رب فيقول الله تبارك وتعالى تريدون شيئا أزيدكم." So when the people of the paradise, they will enter the paradise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to them, "Do you want something extra that I can give you?" فيقولون لم تبيض وجوهنا, that have you not brightened our faces? The people of paradise will say, have you not brightened our faces? أَلَمْ تُدْخِلَنَا الْجَنَّةِ وَتُنْجِنَا مِنَ النَّارِ, that have you not entered us into paradise and saved us from the fire? And then Allah, He will فَيَكْشِفُ الْحِجَابِ, and Allah will remove the covering the barrier between him and us. فَمَا أُعْطُوا شَيْئًا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّذْرِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. And they will not be given anything better in the paradise than seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are some of the things that have been mentioned in the Quran, that the Prophet ﷺ has mentioned as well about the paradise. So whenever we find things difficult, whenever the shaitan may come to us and try and make us become lazy in our deeds, and maybe make us think about this world too much, about the things that are happening, maybe sometimes we are going through a trial, some things that are hard, that we're finding hard, then know that this world is only short. كَلَمْحِلْ بِالْبَصَرِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that it's like a blink of an eye. Our life in this world is like a blink of an eye. And that the people of on the Day of Judgment, they will be asked, كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ عَدَدَ السِّنِينَ. قَالُوا لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. And the people on the Day of Judgment, they will be asked, how many years did you live in the world? And they will say, we lived a day or part of a day. So a whole life on the Day of Judgment will seem like as if it was a day or part of a day. So it's not worth becoming sad over the events of a day or part of a day. So whatever we're going through in our lives, and Allah will test us. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He will test us with hunger and fear and loss of wealth and all the different tests that people have in this world. So we can't escape being tested in this world. But if we are tested, then remember the paradise. Remember the description of the paradise. Keep it inside our minds. And remember, if we can please Allah, then pleasing Allah is greater than everything that is in the Jannah. And remember that seeing Allah in the Jannah is the greatest of all rewards. So today's assembly has been about the paradise. It's my last assembly with you guys. So inshallah, make dua that one day, eventually we will meet up together in paradise and we will all be of the same age, 33 years old. People of paradise, not too young, that you cannot enjoy things. And you're not too old, again, that you cannot enjoy things. But 33 years old is the best age. We'll all be joined together in the paradise, inshallah. So make dua for this, inshallah. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.